So, dear students, welcome to back cross method of breeding in self-pollinated crops. As I have already dealt many things in back cross method, now I am going to deal with the for the transfer of recessive gene in your popular variety. If your popular variety is lacking for something or has become susceptible to a particular race, and by the way, the resistance for that particular race is governed by the recessive gene, then it is problematic, of course. Or any trait, if you are willing to change in your most popular variety, if that trait is governed by a single major gene but by a recessive gene, so things become complicated in transferring that particular gene. So today I'm going to deal with the procedure of transfer of that particular gene. For example, I have shown here example rust resistance. If it is maybe governed by the recessive gene, then how you are going to transfer? So what you are going to do first here, you have to select two parents, of course. One is the parent, your commercial variety, where you are going to improve, to have the improvement. And second, for which it has become susceptible. Say for example, if it has become susceptible to rust resistance. And by the way, that resistance, resistance to that particular rust is governed by a recessive gene, and you have got the donor. So you take the donor and you take your recipient variety. In first year, you grow them. Here, this is your variety which is susceptible, which can be said reciprocal, recipient or can be said recurrent parent. Here, this is, you have grown the variety B, which is donor, which is resistant to rust. Small r is smaller, means this resistance to rust is governed by recessive gene. This has to be kept in your mind. This can be called donor. This variety B is called, can be called donor parent or can be called non-recurrent parent. So variety is your own variety in which you are going to have the improvement. So you have grown them, you have emasculated maybe one plant, no problem, one single panicle you have emasculated, then you have here, and then you have get you have taken pollen grains from donor and you have pollinated that panicle, and you have got 30-40 seeds. So that is enough for back cross breeding. So that you have done, you have got the F1 seed. In next year, second year or second season, you grow the F1 plants. You are growing F1 plants here. You see, once you have made crosses between these two, now in F1 you are going to get all the plants capital R small r. Keep in your mind, all plants are capital R small r. Of course, the other genes, you are getting 50% nuclear gene from this donor and 50% genes from this recipient. The 50% genes you have received here from donor, that has to be removed out because they are unwanted, undesirable. Only one gene is required for you. So you have to, that is why you are making back crossing through your recipient pairing. So here, since all plants are capital R small r, means all plants in F1 are susceptible to that particular disease, then there is no need of testing the plants for resistance. As you know that all plants are susceptible. So then you take any plant, you take any plant and you emasculate the penicill, only one penicill, and then you pollinate. You have grown variety A, the recipient variety A, side by side, and you have taken pollen grain and you have pollinated it here. So it was capital R, small r. You have crossed with capital R, capital R. What is happening, you know very well. So F1 is back crossed with variety A. So this was your second year. You have taken the seed after crossing. This penicill, single penicill seed you have taken. And then you are going ahead in third year. What you are doing in third year? This is BC1. You have taken the seed from here, that is BC1 seed, and the plant you are growing in third generation, this is BC1 plant. So now you see here what you are going to get. Of course, you know that very well, the genetics, inheritance of genetics. By this, you are going to get capital R, capital R. Many plants you are going to get capital R, capital R. Many plants you are going to get capital R, small r. So here also you see that all plants are susceptible. So there is no need, as per genetics you see, capital R small r will be susceptible, capital R will be susceptible. So there is no need of testing for resistance. So you can go for selfing. You go for selfing, all plants are self-pollinated. And you take the seed in bulk, no problem. And you grow it in next generation. This is fourth year. Fourth year, once you are selfing the BC1, the self seed will be BC1 F2, will be called BC1 F2. And the generation, once you are growing in fourth year, BC1 F2 generation will be there. So if you are selfing capital R, capital R, you will be getting capital R, capital R. R plants will be capital R, capital R. Once you are selfing this capital R small r, again you are going to get capital R, capital R, capital R, small r, small r, small r. Now you have got small r, small r. See, there is need of testing for resistance or testing for the gene for which you are doing your back crossing. So here you are doing for rust resistance. So all these plants having capital R, capital R, susceptible. All these plants which are capital R, small r, susceptible. So these plants have to be rejected. You are not going to select these plants. So of course, the small r which you have got, many plants you are getting small r, many plants are there which are small r. So in that, what you are doing, here it is very important. You see that these plants are small r, these plants are, all plants are, which are having small r, all plants are resistant to rust. Now you have got your plant which is rust resistant. But since several plants you are seeing, they are your rust resistant, but what you are going to do here, all the plants which are rust resistant here, they all are not similar to each other. You have to keep in your mind this thing. You will not get this thing in your books. By experience, by doing the things, you can experience it. That all these plants are, which are resistant, all plants are not similar. So what you are going to, which penicill you are going to back cross with the recurrent parent? So this has to be kept in your mind always, that the plant which is resistant, as well as looking closer to your recipient, you select that plant and you take the penicill from that plant and you emasculate it, and then you are growing side by side the recipient plant, recipient variety, side by side. You take pollen grains and pollinate it, and you have pollinated it. So in this way, you have come to the BC1 F2 generation, then now you have back crossed it, now you are going to get BC2 seed, because second year, second time you are back crossing it. with the recurrent pine. So the seed will be, whatever seed you are harvesting here, that seed is BC2. So the generation next year you are growing to grow, that will be BC2 population, BC2 generation. So then after back crossing in fourth year, here you have back crossed the resistant plant, which is closer to your recurrent parent. You have back crossed it with the recurrent parent, and now the seed which you have harvested, the seed is BC2, and the population which you have grown in fifth year is known as BC2 population generation. And now you see that this is capital R small r. Once capital R is small r here, all plants in this generation will be susceptible to that particular disease. Then there is no need of testing for that resistance for that rust. So now you select, since all plants are susceptible, now you try to select, and plants are variant. For that gene, all plants are susceptible. For other genes, variation is segregating, generation is segregating. So you select that plant which is looking closer to variety A, to recipient variety. You select that particular plant and you take a penicill and you emasculate it, and you have grown side by side, you have grown the recipient parent, you have grown, then you pollinate it with this. Now you are going to get the seed which is known as back cross 3. So back cross 3 seed you have taken, and you are going to next generation, sixth year, BC3 generation. You are growing BC3 generation. Once you are crossing this capital R small r with capital R, what you are going to get? You are going to get capital R and capital R small r. So again in BC3 also, there is no need of testing, because you know that all plants are susceptible. But you try to self those plants which are looking closer or similar to your recurrent parent. You self those plants and mix the seeds, no problem. You self and harvest them in bulk, no problem. So you are selfing. If you are selfing this, you are not knowing whether you are selfing this or you are selfing this, you don't know. You are selfing this, you are going to get this. You are selfing this, you are going to get this. You are going to get this, you are going to get this. Now you have got BC3 F2 seed. If you are selfing it, you are going to get BC3 F2 seed. And in this BC3 F2 seed, if you are going to grow in seventh year or seventh season, you are going to get BC3 F2 population. So in this, of course, you are going to go for, you are going for testing for the resistance. If you are testing this plant, you are rejecting it because it is susceptible. You are testing this plant, you are rejecting it because it is susceptible. Once you are testing this type of all the plants which are having small r, they are all resistant. So you select that plant, and in that also you select that plant which is looking closer to your recurrent parent, parent A, recurrent parent. Now you back cross that plant, you take a penicill of that plant and you emasculate it, and then you pollinate it with, you have grown side by side a recurrent parent, you are pollinating it with that. So you have got BC4 seed. From here you have harvested BC4 seed, BC4 generation. So earth here you are going to grow BC4 generation. So once you have crossed it small r, capital R, you are getting capital R small r. So here you have to be serious about that. You have got all the plants capital R small r for one gene, means all the plants in this generation, they are all susceptible. So no need of testing for resistance. But of course you are going to select the plant which is closer, looking closer to the recurrent parent. So you are going to cross that plant with the recurrent parent. Here I would like to tell you that you take many plants for emasculation because you are not knowing that which plant is going to give you more closer to your recurrent parent. So you take 2, 3, 4 plants, maybe emasculate 2, 3, 4 panicles of different plants, and you pollinate it with this. And of course you can mix whatever seed you are getting from 3, 4 plants, 3, 4, 5 panicles. They will be of course they will be BC5 seeds. You mix them, harvest them separately, harvest them and bulk them, there is no problem. So in next generation, in ninth year or ninth season, you are going to grow BC5 generation. Once you are going to grow BC5 generation, what will be happening? Capital R is smaller, capital R, capital R. If you are crossing between these two, you are going to get capital R and capital R is smaller. So here also in ninth year BC5, you are also, again you are not going to go for testing because you know that all plants will be susceptible. So of course you have to self all the plants in this generation, in BC5 generation, since all the plants are susceptible, you self them to get this small R. You are interested to get this small R. So you are selfing this or you are selfing this, you don't know. So you self them, harvest them in bulk to grow the next generation. So after BC5 generation, you have gone for selfing. Once you are selfing, you are going to get, if you are selfing this, you are going to this get capital R, capital R. If you are selfing this, you are going to get capital R, capital R, capital R, small R, small R, small R. So of course here you are, if you are growing self generation, that will be 10th year or 10th season, BC5 F2, and in BC5 F2 you are getting these type of plants. So you are going for testing for resistance. So you are rejecting all susceptible plants. The plants which are resistant, you are selecting those plants. Of course for again selfing, you try to select those plants which are resistant as well as similar in phenotype, most similar in phenotype to variety A, to your recipient. You select them and harvest those resistant plants separately. You have harvested them separately, and then in 11th year BC5 F3 progeny, you are going to grow after that. So you grow individual plant progenies in progeny rows. Of course all plants are resistant, but you are going to see that now the plants are in which row all the plants are have attained the homozygosity, and they are very similar to your recurrent parent. You select that particular progeny, the progeny which is very close to your variety A, the recurrent parent, and of course that is resistant. So you can go for testing. So you select that progeny and you bulk, you harvest that progeny in bulk, no problem. So far you are next year you are going to go for replicated yield trial. So in 12th season or 12th year BC5 F4 generation, you are going for replicated yield trial, of course along with check variety. What is here your check variety? Your check variety is your recurrent parent, so that you must compare all the traits are similar to A, the variety which you have developed, the improved variety which you have developed, almost all characters are similar to that, then only farmers will accept your variety. So you take that one, you have Czech variety, you put that along with some more Czech variety you should keep to justify that how it is similar to other varieties or how better it is to other variety. So if you are finding that your variety is yielding similar to your variety A, or if your variety is yielding little bit better than variety A, no problem, but most of the traits, the phenotype must be similar to that. But of course, if your variety is lower yielder, that will not be accepted. So that should be kept in your mind. So now you have seen that all things are okay, then you are sending this material to All India Coordinate Trial. Since it is an improved version of the variety, so no extensive coordinated trial is required. Earlier it was 1 year was enough for that. Nowadays 2 years instead of 3 years, the normal varieties are being tested 3 years, though this type of improved varieties are tested in 2 years only. So for 2 years, 13th year and 14th year, these varieties, this new genotype will be tested in All India Coordinate Trials along with your Czech parent, Czech variety, recurrent parent, and other checks also are included in that. And after that, if it is successful, then in 15th year, BC5F6 generation, you go for release and sealed multiplication. So now you have developed an improved version of improved Sambha Masuri, improved Swarna, or whatever, for what trait you have, you can put that name also, Swarna Drought or Swarna Submergence, like that you can put. So farmers are going to accept it easily because it is the same variety. So this is all about this backcross breeding method. Some more genes, how they are being transferred, I will be dealing in my next lecture. Thanking you very much.